Hey ladies, welcome back to my channel. We're doing a hair tutorial today. I'm going to put everything I want. I'm not holding back with anything. I want to have texture. I want it to be big. I want it to be loud. I want it to be unruly. That's what I'm going to do today. There's no sleek bob. There's no traditional style that I normally have. I'm going for it. And also, I have no makeup on. As you know, this is just how I show up. So I'm going to do a little cheat sheet on my eye area with my eye brightener. I just have to feel like I'm at least concealing, brightening up this area while I spend my time with you this morning. I don't really love, I don't love like the darkness underneath my eye area. So I'm going to just brighten it up. And this is an actual simple step you can do. Say you're running out to the grocery store or you're not going to be, you know, you don't have time or what have you. You can easily do an eye brightener. It is a nice thin veil of brightening. Put on some mascara, a little gloss while I speak about it. This is a hair tutorial, but you know what? I have to put my vitamin E so I can get through the tutorial and not feel like my lips are sticking together. So we just have a little spruce up. I haven't done the eye primer yet. That's okay. I just needed to, I needed to brighten my face underneath so we can get through this. So I have the microfiber towel that soaks up all my hair, all my water in my hair. This is the best thing ever. This is one of my favorites because it actually is thicker than the other ones that I have. I will link it below. And they have, this is my tropical, you know, there's a reason for everything that I have. Everything I have, whether it's my nail color, whether it's the pattern on my microfiber, just makes me happy. I'm intentionally doing things that when I reach for them, I have a certain feeling, you know, especially I sprayed my Rose 31 from Le Labo today. And honestly, it just gives you a certain feeling. I'm going to be putting my mousse bouffant, which is from Kérastase, into my hair. I'm gonna put it at the roots. I like to concentrate on the crown area and on the sides and keeping the mousse on my hand, not on everything else. And I like to grab it down to the roots. I'm not really that precise about all of my, you know, I just do it. I'm not like, oh no, I didn't put it, oh, it's too much on my hair, not my scalp. All right, let's go back and do a little bit more on the crown area. Get down to the scalp area there. And then I just concentrate on this part. I don't do anything underneath. I just concentrate because I want to really lift this part of my hair. I should put a warning on the video for any of the hair police that get very bothered by hair being on my shoulders. This is going to be a very hairy tutorial. I know it. I can feel it because anytime, you know, I shed a lot, and that's just how it is. So I'm going to be putting the blow dry cream that I love also from Kérastase. I'm going to put like 2 or 3 pumps in, and I concentrate on really the ends of my hair, the areas that I have more of the frizz, the unruly hair right in here. So I'll put and coat my hair with this product. The brush that I use is the Mason Pearson brush. I got the mini so it can fit into my makeup bag and also just be easy to transport when I'm going on set, what have you. But this is a really great brush. This is an iconic brush. It is an investment. I made this years ago and it hasn't changed. It hasn't had any issues. So I was happy that I invested in that. And then I have the Dyson Airwrap. As you've seen on my channel before, I did invest in this because my other one that really worked well, I just felt like it was heating my hair up too hot. And it was 2 years that I was maybe a year and a half I was working with that. I got it on Amazon, really inexpensive. I think I paid $45. It was wonderful, but my hair had enough, so I had to change. Also, I wanted to mention, I use this is a new product that I bought from the Sephora sale. You know, I told you I bought like 5 products. That was it. This is a delicate volumizing conditioner from Christophe Robin. And it has with rose extracts, uplifted roots, and fuller lengths. So I bought this. It smells amazing. And I also bought the clay shampoo, the volumizing shampoo. I thought it was really interesting. But when I opened it, it was brown. Like it was very, very dark. And so I thought, okay, no, Nicole, don't do it. Don't do it. I was so tempted. It smelled so amazing. But I thought brown in the silver hair, it's not going to be a good idea. So I was very disappointed and I was very reluctant to return it, but I thought there's just no way I can do that. Like, let's not do that. That would be a whole nother issue. Oh my gosh. So I just used that volumizing. I used the Kerastase shampoo and I used the volumizing conditioner, which is new. So we're going to see if it's going to give some extra volume into my hair ends. And I am clipping my hair up. I start from the bottom and I work up, even though I concentrate on this triangle on the crown of my hair. That's really where I want that. You know that I have my trusty Velcro curlers by my side. I'm going to just really now just smooth my hair, get it dry, and then we're going to go in for a special technique. You're gonna see that I get a lot of lift using the Dyson. This is really amazing. This is something that I really saw when I started using this, that it really lifts my hair, gives it that bend. Also, I've mentioned this before in my hair tutorials that it has a cool button here. So I can cool shot, I can shoot it with the cool hair, the cool air at the end, so it really seals it and it really makes it last longer, which I love. So I don't get a lot of heat to my hair constantly. I can change it to the cool, and that's really the secret sauce. It's going to really set the curl, the bounce, the lift, and I really, really love that because that is something that my other hair tool didn't do. So I have the first layer done, and then all I do is I just take down this little section. I'll go like that, just take the rest down and just keep working up. So it's much easier. If you try to dry your hair all down, you're not going to get a really beautiful polished salon look because it's impossible to dry the hair really nicely, smooth it, get it looking and laying the way you want to, and then you want to build upon that. So you're really getting that nice polished blowout. You're not trying to just dry your hair all at one time because you really need to take time on those sections to really give it that bend, that smoothness, and have it lay right so this will lay right over it. So that's what I have really noticed. I could never, oh, it's such a nightmare if I just try to, if I air dry my hair, no. If I just say, oh, no big deal, like it's kind of dry, I'll just go in with it real quick. No, I have to really section out my hair and build on it so it really looks polished and really together. So now, even though I'm doing a smooth kind of blowout right now, that's all right because I'm really concentrating on the lift, the volume part, and then I'm going to go into just a little bit of a different technique for my hair. This is a traditional blowout that I do, the traditional style that you always see me in, but I'm feeling a little wanting to mix it up. That's why I am doing something different and using a couple different products, and we're gonna see what it looks like after. Something that I really noticed using the Dyson is that it dries my hair so fast. So this is actually not only a really great 5-in-1 tool, but it really speeds up everything for me. So that's really a nice factor too when it comes to the Dyson Airwrap. So here I'm at the crown. I'm going to just section out each one, and then I'm going to really concentrate on doing a root, lift, cool shot. That's kind of like the system I do. I know you can't see me doing the cool shot, but that's what I'm doing. So I will get it to the point where I'm almost dry, and then I'll give it the cool shot. I am drying it pretty much dry, and then I'm going to go back in with a different technique. That's the way I want to do it today. Also, this beautiful volumizing with rose extracts conditioner smells like in my hair, smells like I did a hair mist. So as I'm blowing it, I'm smelling this beautiful rose extract, and it smells so nice. Very, very light. Not, you know, if you, I know a lot of people don't like rose scents, but this is just so beautiful. I mean, all the rose fragrances I choose aren't your typical rose fragrances. They're very complex, they're very different, they're very moody. So I love that it actually still has that nice, beautiful fragrance after you've washed it out of your hair. To make sure the roots are really dry. That's really my objective with this so far. Now, my hair is a little damp in the front, which is what I want. So I'm going to change out my Dyson Air to my air wrap. So you have two of them with arrows. So basically they tell you which way the hair is going to go back with the arrows. So you have one for the right side and you have one for the left side. So you just snap it on and then you're going to go with where the arrows are going. I want my hair to be with a little personality today. So, you know, I normally do this kind of sleek, just very polished bob, but we're going to go in with doing some texture. And my hair really does very well with this. It's very low heat on with the air wrap. I takes a little bit of time to kind of figure out looking at in the mirror and like going back, but really does the work for you. When you turn it on, it just grabs your hair and it goes back, and then it gives you this beautiful texture. So you're gonna see in 1 minute. I'm going from this to, just wait. I just did the cool shot on it. Look at that beauty. And this isn't with a curling iron that you're like burning your hair. So I just take little sections out and I really just give some personality, some texture to my hair, and it doesn't take me forever. I love just giving this bounce and this bend. It doesn't have to be over the top Shirley Temple curls. That's not really what I'm going for. I just want something that's going to give it life to my hair and not be just kind of like typical bob. Also, if you really want to maximize this curl, you can take, once you just take it right out, you can take your Velcro curler and just go like this, wrap it around and set it. So then you're going to have it being set while you do the rest of your hair. So when you take it out, it's going to be like this beautiful texture. So I'm gonna keep working around. I just want to get some personality, as I have said throughout this whole entire video. It's very exciting for me. So I'm gonna just take my hair up again. I have to section out because I don't have layers in my hair. So we're gonna just see, this is Monday and this is Friday weekend. Let's grab a beautiful cocktail, right? So we're gonna go cocktail today, not Monday hair. it real, ladies. My hair is definitely defiant in a lot of ways. So some days are better than others when it comes to curling and fighting with this thing. Sometimes it will wrap right around like a beauty, and other times it's doing its own crazy thing. So you can see though, I have a lot of texture. I have, you know, I still have that smoothness. It's not too crazy. Do you remember that picture that I did it for a campaign with Caudalie. I did something totally different, totally off the wall. I had my hair, my stylist curl my whole head for that. I mean, it was really so different. It's like this, but this is like the downgraded version of that. Cause I like having a little bit of smoothness. I like the volume here. I like getting texture, and you know, just, you can use a texturizing spray. Also, you can tame it out. You don't have to have it like going crazy frizzy, but my hair really has a mind of its own a lot of the time, and it likes to do its own thing. So I have to really manage it, and hence why I keep it in a bob, because it's a lot easier for me to manage. So I can get that texture. I can get something different. I can have a little bit more personality with my hair. Like I said, it's really like Monday hair, all sleek and polished and what have you. And then Friday, I just felt like letting it go, right? I just felt like, let's get something going. And then like, let's do beautiful makeup and like really look forward to the weekend. I, even though I'm smelling this beautiful rose essence, I'm going to put my rose of no man's land. I know, I keep using this because I just love this hair mist. I mean, I really do. It really, I don't know what it is. Like the second I smelled it, I was like, okay. And move over all of my other hair mists. I don't know if I'll use you. But this is going to be something that will fall. It's going to definitely relax a little bit. So I don't mind it being a little crazy right now in here, giving me that sassy kind of feel. Also, it's not a hack, but like I said, if you really want to set this curl, I would suggest using Velcro curlers, because that's going to keep, you're going to have the heat, you're going to put it right into the curler, and then you're going to set it, you'll do your makeup, and then when you take it down, you're going to see that really beautiful bounce, and it's going to give you that volume, and it's going to, you can even like, you know, spray it with your hairspray while you have it in the Velcro curlers. You can even do a shot of your blow dryer on low because you don't want it to go everywhere. You could also do that to set it in. So there's a lot of things that you can do to really kind of mold and give your hair some personality. This is really just, you know, you'll see that it's still, you know, tame, and then it's like not tame, but that's really what I wanted. I wanted it to be like semi in between, not too curly like I had done before, because it would really get big. So this is just something different, something just to add a little personality into your hair. You can just do the front. You can put this up in a ponytail and have the curls with your ponytail. Maybe you always do a straight ponytail, or maybe you always have been flat ironing your hair and you want something different. Why not? Experiment with your hair. If you hate it, you can just spritz it with water and start over, or slick it back into a bun, or slick it back to the side. There's so many different ways to really have your personality expressed day by day with your hair. And that's kind of like what I love to do, because I think it's always such a mood with your makeup, with how you wear your hair, with what nail polish color you choose. So ladies, I hope you enjoy just a simple, easy, new products. This is the way I do it when I want to have a little extra something in going on in the front of my hair. And you know, just really looking forward to the weekend and just having fun. So until my next video, I'll see you later. Stop.